session Hydro Flask this morning. So yeah, we are officially moved back to Oregon, and this is my bedroom. Very, very small. Freya's bed is right there. Her dollhouse is right there. You know, everything's kind of just slowly finding its place around here. We've been back since August 1st, and it's been madness since we got back. As soon as we got back, we had so much to do around our house and so much to clean after, you know, our renters were living here for the last 2 years, and like, there's just so much to do. And not only that, we had our baby shower shortly after we got back. I am still pregnant. If you're wondering, I'm kind of wearing like a big sweater, so you can really tell, but I am still pregnant. It's been a fucking month, that's for sure. I am tired. The kids went back to school. Freya had her first year of school ever. She started preschool on Monday. And she's been loving it, as I knew she would. She's such a social butterfly. She loves school, she loves friends. And yeah, but we have to get up at like 6:30 in the morning, and then that's when my day starts, and it's just madness after that. So a typical morning for me is like, get up at 6:30, go wash my face, brush my teeth, get dressed, then I wake Freya up, get her ready, and then she eats a small breakfast every morning, and then we drive her to school, and then she eats breakfast at school and brushes her teeth at school and stuff like that. Then by the time I get home, it's usually about like 8:15-ish, and I have to wake Brayden up for school because he starts at like 9:20. So I wake him up and make sure that he's up and getting ready and making him breakfast. And yeah, it's just, if you have kids in school and they go to different schools and they're in different grades, it's a struggle, and I feel for you. Brayden also started football on Monday. He also started boxing, so he goes to school and gets out at 4 o'clock, and he goes to football till 6 p.m. Then we pick him up. He has an hour, or he has like 30 minutes, so we come home so he can pick up his wraps and change his clothes just to go and be at boxing by 7 p.m. across town. And then he's there until after 9 p.m. Like, they didn't get home until I think like 10 o'clock yesterday, maybe a little later. And then he comes home, he showers, goes to bed, wakes up in the morning, and does it all over again. I'm tired. I can't imagine how he's feeling. It's been really good for him though. Before, he was just wanting to play video games and stuff like that. So I'm really relieved that he's like taking sports seriously and stuff, and he really wants to do well with boxing and like, you know, have fights and everything, which he has to work hard for. And he's very determined, and so I'm proud of him for that. I'm just busy all the time. And not only that, like, my house has been in shambles. I've been like trying to get everything ready and in place before the baby comes. As of today, I'm 36 weeks and 4 days. I'll be 37 weeks on Saturday. And truthfully, I'm like miserable, and I swear she's trying to come out vaginally. If you've been here, you know that I've had 2 C-sections, and I'm planning my third. I just have this feeling that she just wants to come out. Like, I'm literally gonna go sit on the toilet one day to take a shit, and she's just gonna, you know, fall out. Let's hope that that doesn't happen, but like, for real, I have so much pressure down there. Pelvic pain, hip pain, back pain, things that I've never experienced before with pregnancy. And honestly, this pregnancy in itself has been different. I found out that I have more fibrous foods, and also just take the iron supplement as well as my prenatal, and I'm good. They're not worried about it at all. But you girls never had any of that before this pregnancy. Not with my daughter, not with my son, like, none of it. So this pregnancy has been full of, like, new things. I'm just miserable. I'm constantly having Braxton Hicks contractions. Again, new. And they're constant. Like, they're not painful, and they're not constant to a point where, like, I feel like I'm in labor, but it's like I'm having at least one or two every hour. And I make, like, sudden movements, or if I'm moving around too much, then my Braxton Hicks are like 10 times worse. I'm so sorry about that annoying ass dog. The people behind us have like a bunch of little chihuahuas, and they're so fucking annoying. They're constantly barking. Like, shut the fuck up. I'm trying to take it easy, but it's really hard to do that when you have kids at home already and you just moved. Like, I'm still trying to get things, like, in order to a place where I'm comfortable with going into labor. Like, I want to know that my house is going to be okay if I do go into labor. Like, everything's going to be in order. I'm 36 weeks, 4 days. They have scheduled my C-section for September 28th at 9:30 a.m. So, hopefully, she stays in. She's gonna be a Libra baby. She's very low. She's head down. I feel like I'm constantly going to the bathroom because she's literally right on my bladder. And there's like, if I'm not on the toilet 24/7, I feel like I'm literally peeing myself. I've been miserable, like not sleeping at night, tossing back and forth. Thankfully though, she's dropped so I can breathe again. Like, not 100%, because she still kicks the shit out of my ribs, but I can breathe. Like, she's not so far up here, like, you can kind of tell, like, she's low. Pray for me, because I'm nervous. Even though I've had to, I know the drill, I know how it goes. There's just something very unsettling about being cut open and having your baby ripped out of you. And knowing that it's not natural. Shut the fuck up. I'm literally gonna kill that fucking dog. I'm gonna go feed it some, like, chocolate or something. I'm done. I'm just kidding. I would never do that. It was a joke. But for real, shut the fuck up. How do I forget that I have coffee when it's just sitting right in my hand? Because I've been yapping this whole time, that's why. It's just an AeroPress coffee with some pumpkin spice creamer. So fucking good. I am so excited for fall. We're starting to get fall weather. It's so cold here in the morning and at night. And then there's just like a breeze during the day. And I think yesterday was supposed to be our very last hot day. And then it's gonna be in the 60s, and like, it's gonna start getting cloudy next week, and it's gonna be very moody. I'm so excited because I'm over the heat, literally over it. Arizona's still having like 100 degree weather, and I'm like, bitch, I'm glad I ain't there anymore. It's been so nice to be home and have my sisters back, and my parents and grandparents and all of that. However, I will say, sorry, I have heartburn and acid reflux so bad. It was nice to be away because nobody invited us to do anything. Like, we didn't have obligations to be at places. And now that we're back, like, we're invited to everything. And we have, whatever, I told everybody to just stop inviting me because I'm not fucking coming. So we're pretty much all ready for baby. We're going on Tuesday to get the car seat and the stroller with my dad, because that's my dad's, like, baby shower gift to us. Not only that, he also made all of the food at my baby shower, which there was, like, probably at least 60 people at my baby shower. So he made a lot of food, and there was a lot left over. Jamie's crib together, like her bassinet, because I got a little side sleeper, like, bassinet thing. I'm not gonna go sleep with this baby. I'm gonna try to keep her in her bassinet, but we will see. I mean, I have nothing against moms that co-sleep. I co-slept with both my kids. My son slept with me until he was, like, 10. He's 13. My daughter slept with us up until, like, a few weeks ago. Which, that's been a transition in itself. She hasn't done terrible, but she still will wake up at night sometimes, and I'm trying to nip that in the bud because I can't have her waking me and the baby up when I'm already gonna be sleep deprived and she shares a room with us. It's gonna be hard. I wish that we had at just one more room in the house, but we don't. We have a two bedroom, one bath, and our house is old, so it's tiny and there's not a lot of room, but we will make it work. We're so happy to be back in this house. Once I have the baby, I'm healed and I'm doing better. I want to get my garden beds ready to have for spring, and I want to get chickens. I have a bunch of plants. I hope you all are doing well, and I'm so sorry I haven't posted in so long. I literally have been so busy, but I've been wanting to post. However, I do post shorts every so often, so watch those. We went to the beach last weekend as our, like, not baby moon, but, like, just our last, like, trip of the summer to say goodbye to summer and welcome fall, because we're going to be welcoming a new baby, and just our last trip before, you know, literal chaos, like the kids starting sports and all that. It was a lot of fun, and it was beautiful over there, and we had a great time. We went to Rhodes End in Lincoln City, which is a beach in Lincoln City. But yeah, all is well over here. I just wanted to give you guys a quick update. I am pregnant, I am having a baby soon, and I did survive our move back to Oregon. Kids are back in school, back in sports. Riley's working fully remote, and he loves working remote. He's actually been going to boxing with Brayden too. Excuse you. I'm so excited that I got to sit down and, like, update you guys, because it's been a while. It's been, like, well over a month, I think, since I last posted. I don't really know. I plan to do a what's in my hospital bag and what's in my diaper bag video soon. Let me know if you'd be interested in seeing that. I love you guys. Thank you for being here. If you've stuck around,